Well, we are still continuing to track this coastal low as it continues to work its way all the way up the coast, bringing inland moisture, clouds, and still some windy conditions across the region. Now, we are finally starting to get on the tail end of this system as it continues to lift northward across the region, and that's going to finally bring us some drying conditions, at least for a little bit of time as we move into the next couple of hours and especially as we work into tomorrow. Now, as far as rainfall totals go, it took a little while for the system to actually get into our area yesterday, but once it did bring some heavier downpours, not just yesterday, but still continuing into much of today. So most of the region picking up at least measurable amounts, but areas highlighted in the green anywhere from about a half an inch to upwards of an inch or so of rainfall or more over the last 24 hours. Areas highlighted in yellow, that's even more. So we're talking 2, even potentially 3 inches of rainfall in a few spots. So you still could see some ponding along the roadways, especially areas that are on the higher side of those rainfall totals. But for the most part, things are going to start to clear on out and warm on up as we move into the next couple of days. Now, moving into tomorrow, we do still have that potential for a few isolated showers, but certainly trending quite a bit drier than where we've been the last 2 days or so. Temperature wise, although it is still below average, this is going to feel a bit more comfortable considering where we've been yesterday into today, as temperatures did remain fairly steady in the 60s for most of the daytime. So we'll be back into the 70s for most of us tomorrow, even pushing the mid to upper 70s as we get into tomorrow afternoon. Now, as far as the rest of this rainfall goes, I know we've got a lot of holiday weekend plans going on, so let's time things out. Through the rest of this evening, still could see a few lingering showers. Isolated storm or two certainly possible, but I do expect that threat to be very minimal at this point. Moving into the overnight hours, still spotty showers possible. Notice the heaviest of that moisture now lifting towards the north and northeast. So areas like Rutherford County still could tap into a little bit more rainfall as we head towards late tonight into early tomorrow morning. We're really just looking at a few lingering showers waking up tomorrow morning with partly sunny skies. We'll see a mix of sun and clouds throughout the daytime tomorrow. Overall, mostly dry through much of our Memorial Day as we get into Monday. Once we get into the afternoon and into the evening, that's when we start to get into that potential for isolated pop-up showers and storms. Not expecting this to be widespread by any means. So if you do have any plans for tomorrow, just keep an eye on the radar. Keep an eye with our forecast as we continue to monitor some of these isolated pop-up showers and storms. Again, not going to be a washout, but you might be hit by a storm or two moving into our Memorial Day. Now, we're not done with the rain, though. We're still going to see that potential for almost daily chances for pop-up showers and storms over the course of the next 4 to even 7 days. But I don't expect any day to be a washout at this point. So that's the good news there. So looking at the 4-day, Memorial Day, isolated pop-up showers and storms, highs right in the mid-70s. We see a gradual warming trend over the next couple of days, keeping the rain chances in the forecast almost each and every day this upcoming week. As of right now, it looks like Friday and Saturday are appearing to be the drier of the days, at least for the upstate. Different story for the mountains. We keep those rain chances in the forecast with temperatures gradually rising near normal to slightly above average by the end of the week.